recording. We are recording. Alright, welcome ObaboJaggas. Or whatever you guys are called. Viewers. This is Bywall. And today we're going to be doing a little introduction video on Street Fighter V. Now this game came out just over a month ago. About 6 weeks ago. And it's on launch. The game was missing quite a few modes, so you had online, you had ranked match, casual match, you had the versus mode, local two player, just like you'd expect, and survival. But it was missing shop, and it was missing challenges. Now, I'm one of those people that actually likes to sit down and go through all the character challenges, even though the combos aren't optimized, and in a real world scenario, you're not really going to be using those combos. I mean, you might, you know, if it teaches you, say, from Street Fighter 4, if you were to do jab, low forward into fireball with Ryu. I don't think that was one of the trials, but I mean, that's kind of one of his bread and butter, like, hit confirmed combos. Whereas I think with Rashid, there might be one of the combos that has you do like standing strong, crouching forward into like, well, whatever, the spinning mixer, which is, yeah, I guess people use that. But to be honest, the game's kind of new and I'm new to the game. So I really haven't been watching much of that. I haven't really watched very many match videos, nor have I really played a lot. I think I've logged about 10 or 15 hours into this game, according to Steam. So, you know, just it's a fresh game, kind of a fresh start. I don't just sort of getting into the, sort of getting used to the combo mechanics in this game. Learning pretty quickly that it's a completely different game from Street Fighter 4, but I like it. So yeah, I went to NCR, what was that, last weekend? If I actually get this out on time, it would have been last weekend, here in Sacramento, and that was a lot of fun. I got to meet a bunch of people who actually might be interested in coming down here to Sacramento and maybe hosting like a, maybe not a weekly, but a monthly thing for however many people show up, 10, 20, 50, whatever. I don't expect it to be that big, but it'll be cool to get to meet people, sorry, as the game's growing, where everybody kind of has an equal footing starting out. But yeah, I feel like this game's got quite a lot of potential as far as hype. Definitely felt like watching, let's say, even Ultra Street Fighter 4 at Evo Top 8 2015 was pretty intense. That was, it had some really good matches, lots of nail-biting moments. Now in comparison, NorCal Regionals is not that big of a tournament compared to Evo. It's maybe 10% of the size, maybe even less than that. Actually, definitely less than that. But I still felt like, even with the little bit of a international crowd that we had at NCR, we had some players from Japan, from Korea, I'm sure some from Europe too, East Coast for sure, that even the matches during the top 8 at NCR were super exciting. Like, I would venture to say on par with, maybe not Evo Top 8, but definitely, like, close to there. And being in the moment, being at NCR, was a whole different experience than just being, what they would call a stream monster, where I'd sit home, you know, with a bag of chips or whatever, and just watch the stream. That's really cool, that's really exciting. But actually going to the tournament was a lot of fun. I didn't actually compete, but I got to play quite a bit of casuals with this other guy, actually the only other guy there that had PC. Everybody else was playing on PS4, and I didn't have a PS4 stick, so I was actually kind of stressed out, thinking that I wouldn't actually be able to play any matches when I was there. But luckily, this guy that brought his laptop and had it running off of there, so I got to meet him. I forget his name, but he's a cool guy, and I got to play at least like 4 or 5 people on day 2, so that was fun. But anyway, going to an event versus just watching it online is a totally different experience. You get to see the players up there, and you see their hands shaking, and you see, you know, the stress that they're going through when they're sitting down and they're playing, and you know, the happiness and the disappointment that comes with winning and losing a match. That whole experience is just amazing. And it's very similar to watching like a real sport. Watching a basketball game in person versus watching it on TV, you know, huge difference as far as experience and the feel, the audio, the visual, the, you know, the sensory. It's just a lot more fun. So with that being said, I really hope Street Fighter V grows to be even better than Street Fighter 4, which I thought had a great scene as far as international players and just you know, everybody picking it up. We'd see tournaments all over the place, in Brazil, in Scotland, and in the Middle East, that players would travel out to, and I really hope that that Street Fighter 5 is able to do the same, where, you know, players like Infiltration, who are sponsored by a big company, are able to be flown out to those small type of tournaments. Now, that kind of sucks, because Infiltration is such a good player. You know, there's a very high chance that if there was a tournament tomorrow, and say it was somewhere in South America, you'd get the local people that would show up, and they'd try their best, and you'd see the talent there. But Infiltration would probably just wipe the floor with them. As it stands, I just feel like he has a really good, he's a good player, and he has a really good grasp on this game very early on, and I think that's why he's dominating so well. The US players are catching up. I feel like KnuckleDew and CR he's got the good execution playing Nash. But some of his decisions were just, it just didn't make sense why he would put himself into a situation and then completely give it up by throwing a fireball. He would backdash to get away, to give himself some space. And now Nash's fireball isn't really the fastest in the world. In fact, it's pretty horrible. It's got some pretty bad recovery. So he'd backdash, and then throw a fireball and just get jumped in on him, and then he would lose. but like I said, game's new. Everybody's sort of getting used to it, so we'll see how it goes. As far as this, though, this video series on this YouTube channel, a mix of it might be, I definitely want to do like a couple of the challenges, maybe some training mode, so that I can see myself improve. I think it'd be cool to look back on these and see how, you know, awful I am at the very beginning of this game, and how much less awful I am, say, 6 months from now, playing this game. So, if I stay consistent with this video series, and I hope to, you'll be able to see my progress throughout that whole time. So, with this, we'll try challenges. I think I've done reused trials, or I'm missing a few. So we'll start from the beginning, and give that a shot, and that'll.